the infinite amount of possibilities of things that you can create with wood. It makes you feel so connected just to nature and to trees and other people. And I think it crosses like gender and culture and all kinds of boundaries people start creating with wood. It's very forgiving. My name's Dawne Olson, and we are at Four Winds Boat Shop and Woodcraft, and I'd like you to step into my studio. Started way back when I was young, I always wanted to build things. I was always piddling with trying to make things. But as far as building canoes, it started when I was out canoe camping and went to a museum. There was a workshop there where they were building cedar strip boats. There was a big window into a workshop that other people were attending. And I had never even, I don't think, seen a cedar strip canoe before. I had aluminum canoes at the time, and I thought, wow, they're just beautiful, and people are building them. And then we went to the gift shop before we left, and there was a book there about how the construction process works. And I picked that up, and after I read it, I think I said to myself, I think I understand this well enough to at least try it and see what happens. Couldn't stop. I just followed every page of the book and just did each step that they said to do. Something that, you know, if you're working on it and something unintended happens, you can usually work with that. And I think when people realize, like, it's not that intimidating, just get your hands on it and start doing it, and then find out, you know, well, this isn't what I want. I'm like, it's okay. Just, we work with what we have, and it ends up being just, usually people are very surprised how well things turn out for them when they have no woodworking experience. The Western red cedars, typically the wood that most boat builders use, it's very lightweight, works fairly well, and it's beautiful to look at, of course. And when we usually add, a lot of people want to add accent colors, and those are typically a hardwood of some kind, but try not to use too much of that because it adds weight to the boat. And I like to keep them around 50 pounds if I can, the canoes, lightweight, which is kind of the whole point. I look for the boards that have the least knots. I bring them home, I rip them into a quarter inch strips on the table saw, and then they go through a router table so that they have a little beading cove on them. There's just like a little, kind of fits together like tongue and groove flooring. The strips kind of nest inside of each other with glue. And then they're built around these molds. The idea is you want everything to be really well balanced and symmetrical from side to side. And so the mold is designed so that when you start working, you're building at the gunnels first, that shear line, they call this the shear line. When I set up the molds, I have a level across for that very first strip that I can make sure that they're both an equal distance on either side of the hull. And then the same on the molds, there's a mark that just defines where your water line is from side to side and your center line is. Those reference marks are on there so that you can put your strips so that they will lay so that your boat turns out the way that the designer intended. I think the most popular misconception about the cedar strip boat is that it's just wood and that you have to take such extreme care and it's just so flimsy. I mean, it looks flimsy, right? But this hull is actually completely covered with fiberglass inside and outside. So really it's more of a fiberglass boat. It's just that the wood, you don't see the fiberglass once that process is completed. So the wood is all protected inside of that. And it's kind of a composite, and so they're very durable. I love building, and I want to keep building things. But at the same time, it's like I really want other people to know that they can if they want to. If you really, really want to do something, you should pursue that. And the joy and the satisfaction that people feel when they complete it is just, I mean, that's priceless. It's kind of like having children. Like you raise them and you form them and you take care of them. And when you're working with a person or a couple too, you're working so closely together that those people are kind of come like an extended family. And so when they leave, I take a little moment by myself and put their boat name on the strong back. And then I just think about them. And I wonder, you know, I know they're out paddling, they send me pictures, but yeah, you know, I miss them. I love seeing their boats on the water. I just love the memories that I've made when I've worked with people. So can't imagine doing anything else.